Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/APOD. And today's picture for March the 24th of 2020, well, it is titled A Black Hole Disrupts a Passing Star. So what do we see here? Well, this is an illustration, a drawing showing what might happen when a star gets too close to a black hole. Now, we tend to think of black holes sometimes as cosmic vacuum cleaners sucking up everything around them, which is really not the case. The only way an object would go directly into a black hole was if it hit it head on. And black holes, regardless of how they're thought, are really not all that large objects. A black hole, even massive ones like the ones at the centers of galaxies, are really only the size of maybe a solar system in terms of the area that they contain. So it's not very likely that things would hit them directly. What is more likely is what is shown in this image, and you can see the streaming material from the orbit of this star. In fact, you're actually seeing the orbit that this star had. And as the star comes very close to the black hole, what is really strong are the tidal forces from the black hole. You hear of tides here on Earth, where the moon pulls on one side of the Earth stronger than it pulls on the other, and this causes the waters to flow and give us high and low tides. Well, if something is close enough to an object of strong gravity, that pull on one side compared to the pull on the other side can be strong enough to disrupt the object. And in this case, it disrupts the star and rips it apart. So we are seeing the gases from that star spread across its orbit. And much of that material will continue to orbit around the black hole, just as though nothing had happened, even though the star has been disrupted. The energy and the things that we see from a black hole happen when you're very close to it. And around the black hole would form very close an accretion disk, a disk of material that is slowly spiraling into the black hole. Now, while I say it's slowly spiraling in, it's actually moving at very high speeds in circular orbits around the black hole. And that causes it to heat up due to frictional forces. So it can heat up to extremely high temperatures, reaching millions of degrees, and therefore emitting X-ray emission. So very high energy emissions can come from that disk of material around the black hole. It is once we cross the event horizon, that point of no return, at which point, in order to escape from that distance, you'd have to travel faster than light, that we can no longer know anything about the black hole or see anything that has now entered it. So outside the black hole, we can still learn the things about it. It is only that very central portion that once something crosses that inner limit that we can no longer see anything about. So in our image today, we're actually seeing, what might happen when a star passes close to, but not directly in, a black hole and how it can be completely disrupted and torn apart. So that was our picture of the day for March the 24th of 2020. It was titled, A Black Hole Disrupts a Passing Star. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be Star Wings. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.